requires a little bit of explanation. Several years ago, Viva hosted a party, which I believe was a celebration for the anniversary of the Center for Gender and Sexuality Studies at NYU, which was having its 11th, that's right, it was its 11th anniversary. It was a queer anniversary, not on the day. And Viva hosted a wonderful party and got a bunch of performers together for it. And Anne presented what you were about to hear and see as part of that party. And when I was putting the show together, I was like, it's a perfect time for a recap of one of those ephemeral moments that you think you're only going to ever see once. And no, we get to see it two times. Once then, and once now. And so I present Anne Pellegrini, one of our professors, who I will introduce in a more professorial way later on.
I want to thank the class for your patience during the setup. I know that all of you are really stressed out. This is only the second week in our Gay Investigative Studies class. And this is the end of the F word, Foucault, Freud, Funnel, Firestone, Friedan, and of course the comparative analysis of the Freaky Friday films. So I know we were a little stressed about this, so I thought maybe it'd be helpful. Let's begin.
Tall and tan and young and lovely, the girl from Ipanema goes walking, and when she passes, each one she passes goes, oh. When she walks, she's like a samba that swings so cool and sways so gently, but when she passes, each one she passes goes, yaddy-daddy-da. Oh, but he watches so sadly. How can he tell her he loves her? Yes, he would give his heart gladly. But each day when she walks to the sea, she looks straight ahead, not at me. And when she passes by, what does she bypass? Human bisexuality coming up in 3 weeks. So there has, of course, been a large literature on the girl from Ipanema, and why she does not see the most classic article is, of course, Gayatri Spivak, and the subaltern sing. Many of you have read it, I've taught it many times, without reading it, because that's the best way to teach. Read it, I haven't even taught it yet! But what I gather is that Spivak does a critique of the ocular centrism of the Western episteme, within which the colonized subject can only compare as objects. Now let's go back to this essay, please. Look at your text, the handouts. Don't touch your screens. Follow me. Each day when she walks to the sea, she looks straight ahead, not at he. Note not only the lazy writing, but the bad grammar. People, that bothers me. It should be. Of course, when you say when she walks to the sea, she looks straight ahead, not at him. What do you think of this transmission? This transition between the subject and the object? This is, of course, the problem of colonization. She can never be the subject, she's often the object.
My therapist is in the house tonight. Everything's okay. So the point here, of course, is it's not that the girl from Ipanema cannot see or does not see. She will not see because she has not been seen. Snap! There is, of course, a larger and deeper literature in the world of the grammar of the subject. You, of course, have read the excitable Beach volume by Judith Butler with a special essay on gender performativity in the bikini wax. That is 4 weeks ahead. Check your syllabus after the unit of bisexuality. No bikini waxes are necessary unless you so desire. And somehow it makes me think of Derrida. I'm not sure why, but Derrida also helps us think about the subject-object and deconstructs their relation. And he does so with his cat. I have a cat. He's not here. But Derrida, naked before the cat, sees the cat seeing him and wonders, what does the cat see? In his anxiety, I think it's pussy envy.
He hears a pussy ride of insurrection.
mention of women and another point of my essays. Don't give me that crappy alternate spelling of women. W-O-M-Y-N. Because what you think you're doing is taking the man out of women while you snuck him back in with that pesky Y chromosome. Not that I'm excellent for anything. I prefer the double X version of Nixon. Say it out loud. Sounds like Nixon rhymes with Dixon. Not a lazy rhyme, it's advertising. Womixon. The X is the linked arms of refusal. The X is the linked arms of re-beginning. Love, sex, rebellion. Here, pussy, pussy. Here, pussy, pussy. Pussy riot. Objective case, people.